بسم الله الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. إن شاء الله we continue reading from رياض الصالحين في باب فضل الزهد في الدنيا والحث على التقلل منها وفضل الفقر. A chapter of leading a simple life and the benefits of poverty. وعن النعمان بن بشير رضي الله عنهما قال قال ذكر عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه ما أصاب الناس من الدنيا فقال لقد رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اليوم يلتوي ما يجد من الدقل ما يملأ به بطنه صلى الله عليه وسلم. رواه مسلم. والدقل هو رديء التمر. سيدنا عمر رضي الله عنه in this hadith Nu'man ibn Bashir says, I heard Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu saying, after he mentioned what people are in at that time, at the time of Umar, and the wealth and the luxury the people had at that time, then Umar radiallahu anhu said, I have seen the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a day, and he was starving so much. He did not find anything to eat, even from the worst kind of dates. He couldn't even find something, even the worst kind of dates to eat, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this is a lesson for us in this chapter to lead a simple life. We just look at the table when we sit for dinner or breakfast and eat with our family and see how many kinds of food we have on the table. And when we eat one kind one day, then the next day we don't want to eat it again. And we say, are we eating this every day? Even if it is a meat or chicken or something very expensive, we don't like to eat it in a couple of days consecutively. And this is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of the best creature Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever created sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Umar says, I have seen him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam starving and nothing in his belly sallallahu alayhi wa sallam maybe for a day or more, and he cannot or he could not even find something, anything, even the worst kind of dates to eat at that time sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So just think about our lives, brothers and sisters, and how fortunate we are and how we should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever he gave us. Don't always look for those who have more than you. And we read this hadith a couple of days ago in the same chapter. Don't always look for those who are above you in wealth and luxury, but always look at those who are below you. Only look for those who are above you in knowledge and wisdom. But this life, it is a temporary residence for us. Yes, we can take what we want from halal. We live a good life. Even the most richest Muslim can lead a simple life by spending when it is needed, by eating good food, having a good cloth, doing everything what he or she wants, but in a regular way, or in a way that if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was alive with us nowadays, he will do sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then we can also help some unfortunate brothers and sisters, some needy Muslims and non-Muslims, some humans who are in need of our help. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us more with wealth, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us when we meet him on the day of Yawmul Qiyamah to be among the saved sect, the sect of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So leading a simple life is from Islam. It is one of the things that we should do and take from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Poverty was never something that shameful for us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was considered among this category, and he was saying, oh Allah, I love to be a miskeen, somebody who lives just to have whatever he can go by and doesn't have lots to spend. So inshallah ta'ala we take from that the Muslim who is leading a simple life is the best Muslim. The Muslim who is leading a simple life is closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, closer to the people, closer to Jannatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and away from the shaytan, and away from Jahannam. And nas'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yuwaffiqana ila ma yuhibbuhu wa yarda. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among Muslims who are always thankful for the ni'am of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us always among the Muslims who lead a simple life as the life of our Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannata wa ma qarraba ilayha min qawlin aw amal, wa na'udhu bika min an-nari wa ma qarraba ilayha min qawlin aw amal. Allahumma inna nas'aluka أن توفقنا إلى شكر نعمتك علينا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم وفقنا إلى شكر نعمتك علينا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم دم علينا نعمة الإسلام يا أرحم الراحمين، ووفقنا والمسلمين إلى ما تحبه وترضاه. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا هي أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. اللهم لا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم سلمنا والمسلمين جميعا من كل مكروه وسوء. اللهم ارفع عنا الوباء، اللهم ارفع عنا الوباء، اللهم ارفع عنا الوباء، اللهم اجعله لنا رحمة وطهورا من جميع الذنوب والذلات يا أرحم الراحمين، واجعله لنا مغفرة للسيئات وقربى إليك يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وجزاكم الله خيرا.